IUI is an easy and inexpensive treatment compared to IVF. Many couples would like to try IUI first, but don't want to waste time either. Some men have better sperm numbers than others. This question comes up often at IVF1, where I practice. All other things being equal, how many moving sperm do you need for IUI to be successful? Stay tuned. First, some basics. In order to inject sperm into the uterus, it first has to be prepared. This is sometimes called a sperm wash, though that is a bad name. We are not actually washing the sperm. What we are doing is separating the sperm from the ejaculated fluid and concentrating the sperm into a small volume. I am going to refer to this process as the sperm prep. In order for IUI to work, there must be sperm that can swim up into the fallopian tubes where fertilization happens. Fertility doctors can calculate the number of moving sperm both before and after the sperm prep is performed. Calculating the number of moving sperm before the sperm prep is performed is not very helpful in predicting the success of the IUI, unless the numbers are truly horrible. Most studies have focused on the number of moving sperm after the sperm prep. We call this the total motile sperm count, or TMSC. Research on this topic has been limited because studies involved small numbers of women, or researchers combined data from different fertility centers with different patient populations and protocols. Recently, however, a larger study from a single fertility center in the USA looked at this problem and was able to come up with some more definitive conclusions. This study looked at over 92,000 insemination cycles from 37,500 patients. This makes it the largest study ever published on this topic. The patients studied were typical of a modern infertility practice. About half of the IUIs performed were in patients under the age of 35, and half were older. As you can see, IUI pregnancy rates were lower as women got older. This finding is not surprising. The success rates for all fertility treatments decline with female age. The patients in this study also took fertility medications. Women who took injections of fertility meds, such as Follistim, had higher pregnancy rates compared to women who took the oral medication Clomid. Women who did a combination of Clomid and injections did not do any better than women who took Clomid alone. The chance for pregnancy was similar whether women were doing their first IUI, their third, or even their sixth IUI. What about sperm numbers after the sperm prep? This study found that the optimal number of moving sperm was 9 million or higher. Couples who had sperm numbers in this range had the highest pregnancy rate. Just over 16% of couples became pregnant with each attempt in that range. Their analysis determined that having a higher number of moving sperm, like 18 million, didn't produce any more pregnancies. In other words, once you got over 9 million motile sperm, the pregnancy rates maxed out. If the number of moving sperm was lower than 9 million, however, pregnancy rates started going down. This was a gradual decline. There wasn't any particular number where the pregnancy rate suddenly dropped off. The lower the number of moving sperm, the lower the chance for pregnancy. Even the group with the lowest number of moving sperm, less than 250,000, still had a pregnancy rate of about 4%. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: regardless of age, your best chance for IUI to succeed happens when the total motile sperm count after the sperm prep is 9 million or more. IUIs are going to work better when women are younger and if they use injections of fertility medications compared to Clomid. Even couples with very low numbers of moving sperm can still see pregnancies happen, so it's not futile to try. But the lower the number, the lower the chance for success. This is not the case with IVF, by the way. IVF works well even when there are very few sperm because of a technique called ICSI, where we inject one sperm into one egg. Instead of needing millions of sperm, a handful will do the trick. Finally, attempting IUI up to 6 times also seems reasonable, as the percentage of couples getting pregnant on their 6th try was as good as it was on the first try. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.